Hello students, now let's continue with the second video of the induction motor torque. While the input to the induction motor is electrical power, its output is mechanical power, and for that we should know that some terms and quantities related to the mechanical power. Any mechanical load applied to the motor shaft will introduce a torque on the motor shaft. This torque is related to the motor output power and the rotor speed. So the formula for the torque is, that is the P out, output power, divided by the omega m, that is the angular speed of the motor, and the units are Newton meter, where omega m is further equals to 2 pi nm upon 60. Here nm is the speed of the motor and it is measured in terms of radian per second. Another units are used to measure the mechanical power is the horsepower. It is used to refer the mechanical output power of the motor. Since we as an electrical engineers deal with the watts as a unit, it is used to refer to the mechanical output power of the motor. Since we as an electrical engineers deal with the watts as a unit to measure the electrical power, there is a relation between the horsepower and watts, that is HP is equals to 746 watts. Now let's do one example. A 200 volt 10 horsepower 4 pole 60 hertz star connected induction motor has a full load slip of 5%. Now calculate the synchronous speed of this motor. What is the rotor speed of this motor at rated load? What is the rotor frequency of this motor at the rated load? And what is the shaft torque of this motor at the rated load? Now, starting with the synchronous speed, the same formula, that is 120 F upon P. Here F is 60 and P is 4, that is given in the question, and answer is the 1800 RPM. The next is the motor speed, that's given from the 1 minus S into NS. This formula is from the slip formula. Here the slip is 0.05 into 1800. That answer is 1710 RPM. And the rotor frequency is S into FE. S slip is given as 0.05 into frequency, originally 60. So the rotor frequency comes out to be 3 Hertz. And the last torque, that is P out divided by omega m. Omega m is further equals to 2 pi nm upon 60. P out is 10 horsepower. We convert this horsepower into 700 into the watts, that is multiplied by 746. 2 pi nm is 1710, here 2 pi divided by 60, and this answer is 41.7 newton meter. Let's do one another numerical. A 3 phase 12 pole salient pole alternator is coupled to a diesel engine running at this. It supplies an induction motor which has a full load speed of 1440 rpm. Find the percentage slip number of poles of induction motor. First of all, find out the frequency, as the frequency is not given. We know the number of poles and the number of and the speed for the diesel engine. Now the frequency of supply to the induction motor, that is Pn divided by 120. Here P is 12, N is 500 divided by 120, it comes out to be 50 Hertz. Now the speed of the induction motor given is 1440. Now the number of poles of the induction motor, actually these number of poles are of the diesel engine that is running at 500 rpm. So the number of poles for the induction motor is 120 F upon N. F is 50, that is supplied from the diesel engine. N is 1440, that is given in the question. And these are the number of poles. But the number of poles, we have already said that are always even in number. So rounding off, it gives P is equals to 4. So the synchronous speed for the induction motor now comes out to be 120 F upon P. F is 50 and P is 4. It comes out to be 1500 RPM. So the slip now calculated as NS minus N divided by NS. NS is the 1500. N is the speed of the motor, that is 1440. And it comes out to be 0.04. And in terms of percentage, it can be written as 4%. One another numerical. If the induced EMF in the stator of an 8 pole induction motor has a frequency 50 Hz, that is the rotor is 1.5 Hz, Here two frequencies are given. One frequency is the standard frequency of the stator and another 1.5 hertz that is given for the rotor frequency. Now at what speed is the motor running and what is the slip? F is given 50, FR is given 1.5, so we can easily calculate here slip using this formula. FR is equal to S into F. So S comes out to be 0.03 and the synchronous speed comes out to be 120 F upon P. It comes out to be 750 rpm. So the speed of motor can be calculated as 1 minus s into ns. S is 0.03 and ns is 750, and this one becomes the speed of the rotor. These type of numericals you can easily practice. Now next is the different types of losses in the induction machine. One is the copper losses. Copper losses in the stator, copper losses in the rotor, that is I1 square R1, I2 square R2. As the copper losses are generally represented as I square R, we have already done in the transformers. Core losses are there. Mechanical power loss due to the friction and windage. How is this power flow in the motor? Now in the next slide, the power flow in the induction motor, because there are different types of losses are there. This is the input power to the motor, that is root 3 VI cos of phi. Here we can represent as theta, that represents your power factor. Now the first type of losses are stator copper loss, then the core losses, then there is the air gap between the stator and rotor winding. So there is then rotor copper loss, then there is the friction and windage loss is there, power. Then the other stray losses are there, and finally the output power can be calculated as tau load into omega m, that is the angular speed and torque. So these are the various relations for the power. Input power is under root 3 VL IL cos of theta, or it can, in the terms of phase power, 3 times V phase I phase cos of theta. Stator copper loss is given as 3 I1 square R1. Air gap then calculated as P input minus the summation of stator copper loss plus the stator core loss. Then the rotor copper loss can be given as 3 I2 square R2. Then P convergence is equals to P air gap minus the rotor copper losses. Then finally the output power is P convex minus the summation of this friction and windage loss plus the other stray losses, and from there torque is calculated. These are the torque speed characteristics, and here on the x-axis there is the mechanical speed, and how the with the increase in the speed the torque varies. At starting the torque varies linearly, but after reaching this maximum point the torque decreases. These are the torque speed characteristics. You have seen that the torque increases to up to 400%. This is the full load torque, 100%. So the induced torque is zero at the synchronous speed discussed earlier. The curve is nearly linear between the no load and the full load. In this range, the rotor resistance is much greater than the reactance. So the rotor current torque increases linearly with the slip. There is maximum possible torque that can't be exceeded. This torque is called the pull-out torque, and it is 2 to 3 times the rated full load torque. The starting torque of the motor is slightly higher than its full load torque, so the motor will start carrying any load it can supply at full load. The torque of the motor for a given slip varies as the square of the applied voltage. The rotor is driven faster than the synchronous speed, it will run as a generator and converting mechanical power to the electrical power. So if the rotor is speed is increased above the synchronous speed, then it will work as a generator. These are the motor generator characteristics. If the speed of the rotor increases above the synchronous speed ns, between 0 to ns its action, it will act as a motor. And if ns increases, that is from ns to 2ns, then it works as a generator. Rotor resistance can be increased by inserting external resistance in the rotor of a wound rotor induction motor. The value of the maximum torque remains unaffected, but the speed at which it occurs can be controlled. So, with the increase in the resistance, the value of the torque can be controlled. This you can see here, as the resistance is increasing. Here R1 is less, R2 is increased, R3 increased, R4 increased, and so on. If the resistance is increased, the value of the torque is also changed. There is another one numerical related to the torque. A 2-pole 50 Hz induction motor supplies a 15 kilowatt to a load at a speed of 2950 rpm. Find the motor slip induced torque in the motor in Newton meter under these conditions. What will be the operating speed of the motor if its torque is doubled, and how much power will be supplied by the motor when the torque is doubled? This is how we can calculate the synchronous speed, that is 120 f upon p, 3000 rpm. Then we calculate the slip by using the same formula. Then this we can, as there are no frictional and windage losses are given, therefore we assume there's this torque, and we directly apply this formula p divided by omega m. P is given, omega is 2 pi by n. And this we get 48.6 Newton meter. Now in the low slip region, the torque speed curve is linear and the induced torque is direct proportional to the slip. So if the torque is doubled, the new slip will be 3.33% of the motor speed will be Nm is equals to 1 minus n synchronous, and this comes out to be 2900 rpm. And the power comes out to be torque into omega, and it comes out to be 29.5 kilowatt. Thank you.